I had a plan, and that plan was to present a series of videos dealing with Word, Excel, and many of the other Microsoft 365, or is that Microsoft Office, or perhaps Office for the Web applications. It was rather confusing, and in an effort to reduce the confusion, Microsoft confused us even more. Welcome to my channel. I am Steve Staves, and my goal is to help you make your computing experience easier. We used to deal with Microsoft Office, and even though there were multiple versions, we all knew that Microsoft Office meant things like Word, Excel, Outlook, PowerPoint, Access, and Publisher. Then Microsoft jumped into subscriptions and came out with Office 365. This confused the users of Office. Adding to the mix, we have online versions of Office. Microsoft wanted to reduce the confusion so that now there are three distinct areas of Office: Microsoft 365, Office, currently at version 2019, which is typically updated every 3 years, and third, Office Online. There are so many software programs included in this mix, but to simplify things, these programs can be broken down into groups. There are the Microsoft 365 apps, which include Access, Excel, OneNote, PowerPoint, Publisher, Word. Then we have a look at email and calendar, which are Bookings, Exchange, Outlook. Then we jump into Meetings and Voice, which is Teams. Onto Social and Internet, which would be SharePoint, Yammer. File and content have things like Lists, OneDrive, Stream, Sway. Then there is Work Management, more for business users, which is Mail IQ, Planner, Power Apps, Power Automate, and Power Virtual Agents, and now the To-Do. Then there's even further, which we get into the Advanced Analytics, which is My Analytics and Power BI Pro. Microsoft 365 is a subscription service that ensures that you always have the most up-to-date tools from Microsoft. Microsoft 365 has various options for home, for business, for enterprise, and for education. But because most of us will likely never use the enterprise or educational options, I'm going to leave those two out of this breakdown. So if we jump into the home version, we have Microsoft 365 Family, which includes Access, Editor, Excel, Family Safety, OneDrive, OneNote, Outlook, PowerPoint, Publisher, SharePoint, and Word. Because it's the Family Edition, this is good for up to 6 users. And you also coincidentally get 1 terabyte of OneDrive per user, so 6 terabytes total. Then we have the Microsoft 365 Personal, which is Access, Editor, Excel, OneDrive, OneNote, Outlook, PowerPoint, SharePoint, Publisher, Word, but this is only good for 1 user. In the business side of things, there is Microsoft 365 Business Basic, which includes your Exchange, OneDrive, SharePoint, and Teams. In the 365 Business Standard, there's Excel, Access, Exchange, OneDrive, Outlook, PowerPoint, Publisher, SharePoint, Teams, and Word. Then we have a look at the Microsoft 365 Business Premium, which is Access, Azure, Information Protection, Excel, Exchange, Intune, OneDrive, Outlook, PowerPoint, Publisher, SharePoint, Teams, and Word. There is another one, which is Microsoft 365 Apps. This only includes the downloadable apps, so you have Access, Excel, OneDrive, Outlook, PowerPoint, Publisher, and Word. With a subscription, you will always have the latest features, the latest fixes, and of course security updates, along with ongoing tech support at no additional cost. You can choose to pay for your subscription on a monthly or a yearly basis. And the Microsoft 365 Family Plan lets you share your subscription with your family for up to 6 people and use your apps on multiple PCs, Macs, tablets, and phones. Now, most of the Microsoft 365 plans for business, schools, and nonprofits include the fully installed desktop apps, but Microsoft also offers basic plans with the online versions of Office, file storage, and email. You decide what works best for you. Office 2019, which is the next area that we're dealing with, is sold as a one-time purchase, which means you pay a single upfront cost to get the Office app for 1 computer, And at the time of purchase, whichever version is available. Currently, that's version 2019. However, there are no upgrade options, which means that if you plan to upgrade to the next major release, you'll have to buy it again at full price. There's currently two versions in this area. There's Office Home and Student 2019, which is your Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, and your Office Home and Business, which is the same as the student version, but includes Microsoft Outlook, which is your email program. Office Online is a free version of Office that you can use in a web browser. All you need is to sign up for a Microsoft account with a new or existing email address. This includes things like Calendar, Excel, Forms, OneDrive, OneNote, Outlook, People, PowerPoint, Skype, Sway, and Word. My hope, of course, is that this video helped to reduce the confusion over some of the Microsoft offerings that are currently available. In my next video, I will be going into detail on how to get Office Online, so please hit that notification bell to get an alert when it comes out. I appreciate your taking some of your time to check out my video. Thank you, and have a safe, fantastic day.